Hello everyone, in this video I am going to talk about a very interesting ultra low power display from Invisible. I'll give you details about Invisible displays. I have recently got evaluation kit from Invisible, so I will show you what is there inside the box. I will also tell you what are the advantages of these displays and what are the main limitations, what kind of applications where these displays can be useful, and from where we can buy and in how much. So let's get started. These displays are electrochromic, that means they reflect the ambient light. Best part about these displays are they are screen printed on plastic substrates, so they are very thin and flexible. Now let me share some characteristics about these displays. They have bistability, that means once the segment is activated, it will stay in that state for a certain period of time. So you can see in this graph, the contrast starts reducing but retains 50% of contrast till 2 hours. And if fading is not allowed for your application, you can see here in 15 minutes, the contrast is only getting reduced by approximately 20%. So after 15 minutes, you can give energy pulse so that it regains the contrast again with a very fractional amount of energy, and this display will stay on. They are very thin, so thickness is only 0.3 mm. Activating the segment is called coloring and deactivating is called bleaching. So they have mentioned how much time it takes in order to activate a segment or deactivate a segment. So approximately from 150 milliseconds to 250 milliseconds it takes to color a segment or activate a segment. And around 120 to 200 milliseconds it will take in order to deactivate or bleach. So considering these timings, 250 milliseconds for activation and 200 milliseconds maximum for deactivation, you will be able to refresh display at least one time in a second. Although company do not recommend these displays where you need fast refresh time. These are some of the electrical characteristics where you can see the unique feature of these display, which is ultra low power consumption. And you can see at 3 volt for 4 mm square pixel size, it takes only 0.21 microwatts. And your peak current will be typically 160 microamps. This display uses from 2.2 volt to 3.3 volt to activate a segment and negative 1.2 to negative 3.3 volt for deactivating the segment. These displays can work from minus 20 to 60 degrees centigrade, which is good enough for many applications. You can expect more than 100,000 activation cycles for these displays. So the question is how to operate. Is it easy? Is it complex? Do we need an external IC? Do we need any special IC in order to operate these displays? So it is very easy to operate these displays. You just need to connect segment electrodes and common electrode to your MCU and you will be able to drive directly. If your MCU is driven by voltage which is within the operating limit of display, which is 2.2 to 3 volt, you can connect your MCU with the display directly like shown in the diagram. Otherwise, it is recommended to use a high value resistance in series of connection from MCU pin to common electrode of the display. If you need to use voltage which is more than 3 volt, they have also recommended a very low cost, easy to use circuit with the help of which you can raise the voltage to common electrode and then voltage for other segment electrodes could be higher than 3 volt. For example, if this voltage is 5 volt, you can raise this voltage with the help of this circuitry to approximately 2 or 2.5 volt and then this will work reliably for longer period of time. Now let us unbox the evaluation kit I was talking about. So this is the evaluation kit. If you open, you will find various displays. So there are 3 single digit 7 segment display, 6 single segment icon display, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then one is dual 7 segment display, and 3 are bar graph displays. So this is with 3 segment and this is with 7 segments. Let me show you a closer look. So this is your single digit 7 segment display from the back side. This looks like dark because I was already using this. I'll show you how it works in a couple of seconds. So, very flexible, very thin. This is your dual digit 7 segment display. And this is your bar graph display, or you can call progress bar. And further inside you will find various boards. So this is your clicker board. You can insert the display here, and with the help of this button you can make it off. With the help of this button you can make it on. So let us try with one display. Just pull this connector, insert this, and then you can see how it works. So this is to make it on, off. Coloring, bleach. You can see it is taking some time in order to activate or deactivate. And now you can remove and it stays on. Let me show you another one. So this is one clicker board, very easy to use and quickly test without needing anything extra. Then you have this driver board. So this is nothing but Atmega microcontroller and associated circuitry. And this, with the help of your jumper wires, you can connect to your MCU, and using readily available Arduino code, you can control 7 segment display, single digit or dual digit, with the help of I2C commands. So I'm not sure why they have not auto programmed it so that I can just give power and it should start working. Like it should count from 0 to 99. For dual digit display. Maybe they can improve in the future version so that I don't need to, you know, hook it up, program it, and then I'll be able to see how a 7 segment display works. And then they have also provided this adapter board, so you can just plug it in. So you need to make sure this side is always on the left side. So you have to connect like this, and then you can connect via jumper wires to your MCU board and start playing with this. Basically a breakout board. So that's all inside evaluation kit. Now let us try to understand what are the advantages of this display and what kind of limitations it has. So first one is low power. As I have shown you, it consumes only 0.21 microwatt typically for 1 cm² segment size. That is the biggest advantage. The applications where other displays, because of power consumption, are not suitable, these displays can be used very easily. The next one is, because it is printed on plastic substrate, they are very thin and flexible. You can bend them, fold them. So the applications where flexibility is required in the display, these displays are very, very useful. They are waterproof. Only electrodes we have to make waterproof. They are very reliable. Because it is possible to manufacture via screen printing at high volume, the cost of production is very, very low. So these are some of the advantages of these displays. Now let us try to understand what kind of limitations it has. So first one is slow refresh rate. In an application where fast refresh rate, like, you know, couple of times in a second or at least one refresh per second is required, these kind of displays are not suitable. Company has also mentioned that these displays are only suitable where you need display refresh only, you know, couple of hundred or let's say 1000 times in a day. Refresh rate will also impact life of these displays. So really these displays are meant for very slow refresh applications, and there are many applications in which these displays can be used. Next one is, at the moment there is no display which is available as a graphic display. So right now only segment type displays are available. As it is dependent on ambient light which it reflects, these can't be used in dark. So if you want to make these displays to be used in dark, you need to add some light source. That is one limitation. Another one is, invisible company is not providing any of the shelf displays. So company need to prototype their own custom display based on their requirement. Although they have provided some displays like I have shown you in the evaluation kit, but those are mainly meant for evaluation. So for your custom needs, you need to contact them. You need to pay some upfront prototyping fees and custom developed your displays. That is one small limitation. So that's about advantages and limitations. Let's move on to the applications where all we can use these kind of displays. So I have taken this information from Invisible's website. So one of the application they have mentioned is smart labels. So we all have seen static labels which are printed on paper or plastic, but with the help of invisible displays, smart labels are possible, which can change display based on the characteristics. For example, if we want to show what is the temperature of bottle, right? Or whether it has exceeded threshold temperature and how many times, we can very easily show with the help of these smart labels. Another example is, we can show expiry date very easily, whether it is good to have this food for next 30 days, or we should consume this food immediately, or food is not good for, you know, eating. So it will be very easy for somebody who is buying the food to identify which one to pick, which one to leave it. Another example is display for laundry machine, where it is showing how much water it has saved. Next one is your thermometer, then your low power monitoring solution. So when you have very high value item to be shipped from one place to another, you want to make sure that the product is safe. So you can create a product which will monitor shock, vibration, temperature, and even humidity while in the transit, so that when you receive the product or when user receive the product, they can ensure the integrity of the product. So what else is possible? Because of the low power consumption of these displays, we can add energy harvesting, and a lot of different applications can be possible. Like truly battery-less monitoring system with a display is possible. For example, if you want to monitor temperature, humidity, or indoor air quality monitoring, you can do with the help of these displays, where energy harvesting indoor solar panels are there, which is, you know, collecting or storing energy onto a super cap. And then with the help of the collected energy, it will power the circuitry and sensor and display it on the display. Another application could be soil moisture display. So what do you think? What kind of applications are there where we can use these displays? Please let me know in the comments below. Next is from where we can buy these displays? Are they just a technology, or we can buy these displays and evaluate and, you know, start using in some of our early prototypes? So you can go to their website ynvisible.com and you will see on the top right corner shop button. You can click on that and you will be able to see everything which is available to purchase. For example, the 7 segment display kit which I have shown you is here. It costs 190 euros. Another designer kit is there, which is a colorful display kit. Let me show you. You can see a small video also. And then these bar graph displays are available. So pack of 3 is 15 euro. That means €5 for one display. Similarly, dual digit 7 segment display is available. Then single digit 7 segment display is available. And then they have these adapter boards, click board, and display driver board. And as I mentioned, these are only for evaluation. If your application suits the readily available display size and form factor, you can talk to the company for bulk prices. I hope you found these displays interesting and you're already thinking about evaluating or using it some of your future products. If you have any feedback, please let me know in the comments below. Thank you so much for your time, and I will see you in my next video.